Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to learn about whole numbers. What are whole numbers? How whole numbers are represent on number line? What are the different properties of whole numbers? And how whole numbers are expressed in different patterns? We are going to learn all these things in this video. So, going to the coming to the introduction part of the whole numbers, this one, as we have learned in the previous classes about natural numbers. So what are natural numbers means? The numbers which we use for counting are called natural numbers. So what are natural numbers? It is nothing but starts from 1. 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on are natural numbers. So what are successor and predecessor in natural numbers? We are going to see that. So adding a number to the present number is the successor, and subtracting 1 from the natural number is the predecessor. So now we are going to look for some of the examples. What are the numbers? Now we are going to see what is the successor and predecessor of the given numbers. So here successor means, if the number is present as 2, if we add plus 1, that gives the number as successor. If the number is 3 and we want the predecessor of the number, means we have to subtract 1 from this number, so that gives the predecessor, so that is 2. So he has given here to us, he has given a table of some of the natural numbers. We have to complete the column 2 and column 3, this one. So we are going to do this one. So what is the first number here? The first number is 13. So if we want a predecessor, means we have to do the subtraction, that is 13 minus 1. 13 minus 1 is 12. If you want successor, means what we have to do, we have to add one number, that is 13 plus 1 is 14. Next number is 237. So 237 minus 1 is 236. For the successor, what we have to do, 237 plus 1 is 238. Likewise, we have to do the remaining numbers. What is the next number? 999. So what we have to do, 999 minus 1 is equal to 998. If we add one number, 999 plus 1, if we add 1, it becomes 1000. Next number is 26. 26 minus 1 is 25. If we add 26 plus 1, it becomes 27. Now 9 is the number. So 9 minus 1 is 8. 9 plus 1 is 10. Now we are having a number. For this, we have to pay concentration. What is that? 1. 1 minus 1 is equal to 0. 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. So now what he is asking, two questions here. Discuss with your friends which natural number has no successor. So which natural number has no successor, he is asking. So each and every number is having successor. Which natural number has no predecessor? So this question, in this question we have done here. So 1 minus 1 is equal to 0. 0 is not the natural number, as we have learned here. So what is this? Natural numbers are 1, 2, 3, 4. It starts from 1, not from 0. So we have got here 0. So 0 is not a natural number. Now we are going for the whole numbers. We are taking another slide. What are whole numbers? Now we are going to discuss about whole numbers. So what are whole numbers? If we add 0 to the natural numbers, so that becomes whole numbers. For example, natural numbers is starts from 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. So what are whole numbers? If we include 0 in these numbers, like 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. So these are whole numbers. So natural numbers are denoted by N and whole numbers are denoted by capital W. Now we are going to see what are the So what he is asking, which is the smallest whole number he is asking. In this question, he is asking which is the smallest whole number. So we know that whole number starts from 0. So 0 is the smallest whole number. After that, he is asking two questions. What is this? Are all natural numbers whole numbers? So what are natural numbers? We have discussed that natural numbers are nothing but 1, 2, 3, 4. Are all natural numbers whole numbers, he is saying. So in whole numbers, 0 is there. 0 is not present in natural number. So this is wrong. Or we can say that it is false. Are all whole numbers natural numbers? Yes, of course. Are all whole numbers are natural numbers, he is asking. So here in whole numbers 0 is present. 0 is not a natural number. So this is false. Both are different. Now we are going to learn about representation of whole numbers on number line. So what is this? We are going to learn about number line first and then the representation of whole numbers on the number line. So if this is the number line, as already you have learned in the earlier classes, so we are going to point the markings. So the marking should be of equal distance between them. See, now I am not having scale. Imagine the distance between these two is equal. So in whole number, what we have to do, we have to give 0 here first and then the remaining numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 like this. The number which is on the right side, this is the right side. We can see that on right side the number is increasing progressively. So the numbers on right side are greater. If we see from here, for example, I am taking the example of 8. So to the left of 8, left side, the number start getting decreased. So to the left side, the number is smaller. We can say that. Now he has given a table. In that he has given some examples of whole numbers. What you have to do? We have to say the position of the number on the number line. Now I am going to write other two numbers like 12. So for the first example here, 12 and 8 he has given. 12 lies on the right side of 8. Yes, of course. Here is the 8. 8 is here. And to the right side of 8, it is 12. So 12 is greater than 8. Without seeing the number line, we can say that which number is greater and which number is smaller. For example, 12 and 16 here. So position on number line, he is asking. 12 and 16, 12 lies on left side. So what is that? 12 is less than 16. Next is 236 and 210. So 236 and 210. 236 is the greater number and it lies on, now we are going to write here, 236 lies on right side of number line and 236 is greater than 210. Like this we have to do. We are going to do the remaining one. This one, 1182 9521. So 9521 is the greater number and 1182 is the smaller number. So which number lies on the right hand side? Means this number lies on the right hand side of the number line and this is the smallest number. So how we have to write here? 1182 is less than 9521. So now you have to do the remaining one. So now we are going to discuss about the addition of numbers, addition of whole numbers on the number line. Addition of number on number line. Addition on number line. So for example, if this is the number line and starts from 0 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 and so on. I'm not going to represent all the numbers on the number line. Now if he has given the do addition of 2 plus 3 on number line, so what we have to do? We have to select the first number as on the number line, that is 2. Now we have to draw the line so that it connects the 3 digits. So 2 plus 3 is there, no? Now I am taking as 1, 2 and the last one is 3. So it is falling on 5. So what is the addition? Means 2 plus 3 is 5. For addition, we go on the right hand side. This is equal to 5. Now we are going to see about subtraction. If this is the number line, it starts from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So if the question has given as 6 minus 4, now what we have to do? We have to select 6. What is the first number? Means we have to select that number 6 1 2 3 4. So it is falling on 2. So 6 minus 4 is equal to 2. So for subtraction, the arrow moves towards the left hand side of the number line. So this is the addition and subtraction of the whole numbers on the number line. Now we are going to see the multiplication of numbers on the number line. So before that, we are going to do this. What is show these on number line? What is the first question here? 5 plus 3. We are going to draw the number line here. Start from 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10. So what is the question? 5 plus 3 on the number line. So we have to select the first number from here. 5, he has given 5, no? We have to select here 5. So it's start from here and it is addition, so we have to go on the right hand side. So 5 plus 3, 1 2, and this is 3. So what is the answer? 5 plus 3 means it is equal to 8. What is the next question? 5 minus 3 is asking. So again, we have to draw the number line. It starts from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now we have to select 5. He has given 5, no? 5 minus 3. For subtraction, we have to go on the left hand side. So this is the line 1, 2, and this is 3. Now I'm going to write it again. 1, 2, and this is 3. So what is the answer? 5 minus 3 is equal to 2. For subtraction, we are going on the left hand side. What is the next question? This one we are going to do. 3 plus 5 is the next question. What is that? 3 plus 5. First, we have to draw the number line. Now we are going to write it 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and the last one is 8, 9, 10. Now, what is that? 3 plus 5. So what we have to do, we have to select first number as 3, and then we have to go for the 5 steps. 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is 5, and we have to give our arrow mark. So what is that? 3 plus 5 is equal to 8. What is the next number? 10 plus 1. 10 plus 1. Now again we have to draw a number line. What is that? It starts from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, like this. So it is 10 plus 1. We have to start from here only. Addition means we have to go on the right hand side. That is equal to 11. 10 plus 1 is equal to 11. So what is the answer? 11 only. Now we are going to do the multiplication on number line. How we have to do multiplication on number line, we are going to see now. What is this multiplication on number line? For example, he has given an example of 4 into 2. So what we have to do, we have to draw a number line first. So it starts from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So what we have to do here, we have to start from 0. And we have to take 4 steps each of 2. So what do you have to do? 4 into 2, you already know that it is equal to it, but we have to show this on number line. So we are going to do what we are going to do here. We have to start from 0 and we have to take 4 steps each of 2. So we are going to start 1, 2, 3, and this is 4. So it is equal to 8. So each of step 2 is there, no? This is equal to 4 into 2 is equal to 8. So now he has given some of the questions. What we have to do here? So find the following by using number line. What number should be deducted from 8 to get 5, he is asking. So we are going to do this one. If this is the number line, we start from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So what number should be deducted from 8 to get 5, he is asking. 8 minus some number to get 5, he is asking. So what we have to do, we have to start from the 8 and we have to take till 5. So this is the 8. Now we are going to do this. 1, 2, 3. We stop at 5. So what is that? So we need only three numbers, 1, 2, 3. So 8 minus 3 is equal to 5. I am going to write here again, 1, 2, 3. So 8 minus 3 is equal to 5. Now we are going to do the second question. What number should be deducted from 6 to get 1? He is asking. Again, we have to draw a number line. Start from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So what number should be deducted from 6 to get 1? He is asking. So what we have to do? We have to take like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we have to stop at 1. So he is asking, what is that? What number should be deducted, means what number should be subtracted from 6 to get 1, he is asking. So we are, our answer is 1, and we have to find that number. So how much steps we have crossed? 1, this is 1, this is 2, 3, 4, 5. So we have crossed 5 numbers. So our answer is 5. We are going to see the remaining questions in the next slide. What number should be added to 6 to get 8, he is asking. So if this is the number line, now we are doing the third question, this one. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and this is 10. So what number should be added to 6 to get 8, he is asking. So this is 6 plus which number we don't know, the so that we should get 8, he is asking. So we start from 6 to the right hand side and we end at 8. So we are crossing just 2 steps, this 1 and 2. So the answer is 2. 6 plus 2 is 8. Fourth one, this one. How many 6 are needed to get 30, he is asking. How many 6 needed to get 30? So what we have to do? We have to draw a number line first. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We have to write till 30. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and this is 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26. I'm taking this number line down like this, 27, 28, 29, 30. So because of no space, I'm writing is, it is like this. You can write straight. Now what is asking? How many 6 are needed to get 30? So what we have to do? We have to start from 0. Now we are going to draw the number line like this. So we have to take steps till 30. So and after that we have to calculate how many steps we have done. 1, this is 2, 3, 4, and this is 5. So it is like this. So how many steps we are going to count? 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is 5. So in 5 steps we get 30. So that is 6 into 5 is equal to 30. So you have seen here, I have done 6. 6 plus 6 is 12. Again, 12 plus 6 is 18. 18 plus 6 is 24. 24 plus 6 is 30. So we have got 5 steps to get 30. So that means 6 should be multiplied 5 times to get 30. Now we are going for another page. This is exercise 2.1. Now we are going to do 2.1. So what is this first question? Which of the following statements are true and which are false? Correct the false statement he is saying. So what is this first one? There is a natural number that has no predecessor. So there is a natural number that has no predecessor. Means predecessor means what? If a number is there, if we subtract that number with 1, so we should get answer. So for natural number starts from, we are doing this first one. In this first one, this is Roman number 1. So what is this natural number? Starts from 1, 2, 3 like this. So there is a natural number that has no predecessor. Yes, it is true. This one is true. So what is this? First one is true. Second number. So one is not having any predecessor means this is true. Now we are going to do the second one. 0 is the smallest whole number. Yes, of course. That is also true. What is that? Whole number means whole number starts from 0, 1, 2, 3 like this. So 0 is the smallest whole number. All whole numbers are natural numbers. So here all whole numbers are natural numbers, he is asking 1, 2, 3. In the third question, he is asking what all whole numbers are natural numbers, he is saying. So whole numbers are 0, 1, 2, 3 and natural numbers are 1, 2, 3. So the third question is false. Now we are doing this fourth one. A whole number that lies on the number line lies to the right side of another number line is the greatest number. So already we have discussed that the number which lies on the right side of the number line is the greatest number. So this is true. Fifth one, a whole number on the left of another number on the number line is greater. So what is this fifth one? He is saying that number which is on the left hand is greater. That is false. We are going to do the sixth one here. So we can't show the smallest whole number on the number line. Yes, of course, we can show the smallest number on whole number number line. So what is the smallest whole number? Zero is the smallest whole number. And we can show on number line. So this number, this question is, this statement is false. We can show the greatest whole number on number line, he is saying in the seventh question. So we can't show the greatest number on the whole on the number line because we can't draw number line to that extent to show the greatest number. So this is also false. Now we are doing the second question. This one. So how many whole numbers are there between 27 and 46, is asking. So we have to write the number 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46. So what is the question? How many whole numbers are there between 27 and 46? We have to count from here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. So there are 18 numbers between 27 and 46. Now we are going to do the third question. This one we are going to do. Find the following using number line, he is asking. 6 plus 7 plus 7. So first, what we have to do in the third question, the first one, first we are going to draw a number line. After that, we have to give the numbers. Starts from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and this is 20. Up to 20 we have drawn. So what is the number? Find the following using number line. That is, the question is 6 plus 7 plus 7. So what the first number? We have to start from there. So this is 6. And now we are going to take the numbers. This is 6. Starting from 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Up to here, what we have done? 6 plus 7 is finished. Now we are going for 6 plus 7 plus 7. We should start from here. Again, we have to take 7 steps. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So this is 6 plus 7 plus 7. That is equal to 20. Now we are doing second question of this. What is that? 18 minus 9. We have to draw a number line. Now we have to give the numbers on this number line. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. So what is asking? 18 minus 9. For subtraction, we know we have to move to the left hand side. We are going to select this number as 18. After that, we have to take 9 steps. Now we are going to select this 18. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. This is 18 minus 9. You have to show the arrow mark here. In this problem also, we have to show the arrow mark here. What is this 18 minus 9? Again, it is equal to 9 only. Now we are going to do the third question. What is the third question here? 5 into 3. First, we have to draw a number line. Start from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So, what we have to do? We have to take each step of 3. 5 times. So it should be start from 0. Now I'm going to do 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is 5. So 5 into 3 is equal to 15. This is the answer. So what we have done? We have taken each 3 step, that is, we have taken 5 steps each of 3, that is equal to 15. Now we are going to do the fourth question. What is fourth question? In each pair, state which whole number on the number line. This one we are doing. In each pair, state which whole number on the number line is on the right of the other number. So what is this? In the fourth question, we are doing the first one. What he has given? A pair 895 and 239. So among these numbers, we have to say which number is on the right hand side, he is asking. So the number which is greater lies on the right hand side. So among these number, the number is 895 is greater, so it lies on right hand side. Second one, 1001 and 10001. So this number is greater, so this number lies on the right hand side of number line. थर्ड क्वेश्चन 1001578 अदर इज 284013. सो इन द प्रीवियस वन वी हैव सीन विच नंबर इज ग्रेटर मीन्स दिस नंबर इज ग्रेटर बिकॉज इट इज हैविंग मोर डिजिट्स. सो दिस नंबर लाइज ऑन द राइट हैंड साइड ऑफ द नंबर लाइन. नाउ वी आर डूइंग द फिफ्थ क्वेश्चन. दिस वन मार्क द स्मॉलेस्ट होल नंबर ऑन द नंबर लाइन. सो इफ यू ड्रॉ ए नंबर लाइन स्टार्ट फ्रॉम 0, 1. सो दिस इज द नंबर लाइन. सो वी हैव टू मार्क द स्मॉलेस्ट. सो स्मॉलेस्ट होल नंबर इज 0. सो वी हैव मार्क दिस एज 0. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज सिक्स्थ वन. सो चूज द अप्रोप्रिएट सिंबल टू शो. सो वॉट इज दिस 8 and 7. Between 8 and 7, which is greater? This one is greater. So we have to use the symbol like this. Here. Already I have shown you that the greater than, only two signs are there, greater than, less than, and other is equal. So greater than, for less than we have to remember L we write like this. So this is less than, and greater than means it should be like this, equal, or we all know that. So between 5 and 2, which is greater? 5 is greater. So we have to write like this. Now 0 and 1. So 0 is less than 1. 10 and 5. Between 10 and 5, 10 is greater. So we have to write like this. 10 is greater than 5. Now we are going for the properties of whole numbers. So what are the different properties of whole numbers? First we write here, what are the properties of whole numbers? So there are different properties which whole numbers follows. First we will learn about the closure property. So what is closure property? If one whole number is there and we are adding one whole number, the resultant should be whole number only. For example, whole number is added with whole number should be whole number only. So now we are learning closure property for the different things, like we are learning now for the addition. So in addition, whole number plus whole number should be whole number only. For example, 3 plus 4 is equal to what? 3 plus 4 is equal to 7. So 3 is also a whole number, 4 is also a whole number, and 7 is also a whole number. Another example is 5 plus 0. So 5 is a whole number, 0 is also a whole number. So the answer is 5 only. So this is also a whole number. So whole numbers follow the closure property of addition. Now we are going to see the multiplication. Now we are going to see for the multiplication. Whole number multiplied with whole number should be whole number only. So for example, 2 into 5 is equal to 10. So here 2 is also a whole number, 5 is also a whole number, and 10 is also a whole number. Considering 0, we have to see one example. What is that? 3 into 0 is equal to 0. So here 3 is a whole number, 0 is also a whole number, and 0 resultant is 0. It is also a whole number. So closure property. Whole numbers follow the closure property of addition and multiplication. Now we are going to see the another property in the next page. Here he has given some examples, and now what we have to do, we have to see this one. So here pi into 6 is equal to a 30. So pi is whole number, 6 is whole number, and 30 is also a whole number. 11 into 0 is 0, that is also a whole number. 16 into 5 is 80. So 16 is whole number, 5 is a whole number, and 80 is also a whole number. 10 into 100 is 1000. 10 is a whole number, 100 is a whole number, and 1000 is also a whole number. 7 into 16, the same. So what he is saying, closure property so whole numbers follow whole number follow closure property of addition and multiplication. Now we are going to see the another slide. So here, commutative property. So what we have learned? We have learned the first property as closure property. Now second one is commutative property. So what is commutative property? Commutative property means A plus B should be equal to B plus A. If we are taking one whole number like this, if we are taking a whole number, for example, 3 plus 4 should be equal to 4 plus 3. Now we are seeing this in addition. 3 plus 4 is equal to 4 plus 3. Now we are going to see that 3 plus 4 is 7. 4 plus 3 is also 7. So this means that whole numbers follow the commutative property of addition. Now we are going to see for multiplication. For this is the property A into B is equal to B into A. For example, here A is equal to 3 and B is equal to 4. So 3 into 4 is equal to 4 into 3. 3 into 4 is 3 fourths are 12, and 4 threes are is also 12. So what does it mean? It means that whole number follows the commutative property of multiplication. Now we have to see for the subtraction and division. Is this one will follow the commutative property or not? We have to see that. Now we are going to see for subtraction and division. For subtraction, A minus B is equal to B minus A. Already we have taken that A is equals to 3, B is equals to 4. Now I am going to write 3 minus 4 is equal to 4 minus 3. 3 minus 4 is equal to, now we are going to see that whether commutative property, whether whole numbers follow the commutative property in subtraction. So 3 minus 4 is equal to, what is that, minus 1, and 4 minus 3 is equal to 1. So this is not equal. So what we can say that whole numbers don't follow the commutative property under subtraction. Next, we have to see the division also. So for example, A is equal to 10, B is equal to 5. A divided by B is equal to B divided by A. So A divided by B means 10 divided by 5 is equal to 5 divided by 10. 10 by 5 is equal to 5 by 10. So 10 by 5 is 5 ones are 5, 5 twos are 10. So we are getting 2 here. 5 ones are 5, 5 twos are 10. This is equal to 1 by 2. So these are not equal. So commutative property don't follow under division. Whole numbers don't follow commutative property under division. In the previous topics, we have seen that the closure property and commutative property. Now we are going to learn about the associative property. What is associative property? So associative property is nothing but we are going to learn it separately in addition, multiplication, subtraction and division. Now we are going to start with the addition. So in addition, what is associative property means? So associative property is in addition is nothing but A plus whole of B plus C should be equal to A plus B whole plus C. This is the associative property in addition. Here he has given one example. We are going to see this one. This one. So what is that example? 3 plus 4 plus 5 is the quotient, suppose. So now we are going to consider A as A is equals to 3, B is equal to 4, and C is equal to 5. Now we are going to see that. So what is that? 3 plus 4 plus 5. This should be equal to 3 plus 4 plus 5. So 3 plus 4 plus 5 is equal to 9, and 3 plus 4 is equal to 7 plus 5. So 3 plus 9 is equal to 12, 7 plus 5 is equal to 12. So this means that associative property, whole numbers follows the associative property under addition. Now we are going to see for the multiplication. By taking the same example, I am going to now we are going to see under multiplication. So what is that? Multiplication. In multiplication, what the associative property becomes means A into B into C should be equal to A into B whole C, like this. What we have taken, A is equals to 3, B is equal to 4, and C is equal to 5. Now I am going to substitute these values in this property. What is that? 3 into 4 into 5 should be equal to 3 into 4 whole into 5. So 3 into, what is 4 into 5? 4 5 is 20, is equal to 3 4 is 12 into 5. So now we are going to see that 3 into 2 is 6. Yeah, or we can do here 20 into 3. 3 zeros are 0, 3 2 is 6. So 3 into 20 is equal to 60. And you know 12 into 5 is also 60. So this means that associative property, whole numbers follows the associative property under multiplication also. Now we are going to see for the subtraction and division. For subtraction, so what is that, whether this follows or not? See, if I keep associative property in the subtraction like this, A minus B minus C, so for whole B minus C is equal to A minus B whole minus C, like this. So is it possible? Now we are going to see by taking the same example. What is that? A is equals to 3, B is equals to 4, and C is equal to 5. So A is equal to 3. Now I am going to substitute this in the slide. 3 minus 4 minus 5 is equal to 3 minus 4 minus 5. So what is that? 3 minus 4 minus 5 is minus 1, is equal to 3 minus 4 is minus 1 and minus 5. So what is the answer? Minus into minus is plus, that is 3 plus 1 is equals to minus 6, that is 4 is equals to minus 6. This is not equal. LHS is not equal to RHS. This means that associative property, whole numbers don't follow associative property under subtraction. Now we are going to see under division. So now we are going to see under division. So what we can write here, A divided by whole B divided by C is equal to A divided by B whole divided by C. For this we are going to take one example. So what is that example? We are going to take the same one. A is equals to 3, B is equals to 4 and C is equal to 5. So what is that? A is equals to 3. 3 divided by B is 4 divided by 5 is equal to 3 divided by 4 whole divided by 5. Now we are going to see that 3 divided by 4 by 5. I'm writing it like this, 3 by 4 whole divided by 5. So what we can do here, I'm going to write as 3 divided by 4 divided by 5 is equal to 3 by 4 whole divided by 5. So what we can do here, 3 into, I'm going to write as, in this we are going to see that it is not like this, 3 divided by 4 divided by 5 is there, no, 4 divided by 5. So what is the answer for 4 divided by 5 means? It is equal to 0.8. And here 3 divided by 4 divided by 5, 3 divided by 4 is nothing but 0.75, is equal to 0.75 divided by 5. So which means that we can see here the numbers are so different that, so we can, by seeing the numbers we can say that it is not equal, that is LHS is not equal to RHS. So associative property, that whole numbers don't follow associative property under division. Now we are going to see the another. So here he has given us some examples. So what we have to do, we have to follow the commutative property and associative property to solve these examples. Now we are going to see this, the example 1. So what is this example 1? What he has given, question as 196 plus 57 plus 4. We have to rearrange the numbers and we have to find the answer. So how we can rearrange the number? If we rearrange the number, it becomes a commutative property. For example, 196 plus 57 plus 4 is the question. So what I am writing, 196 plus 4 plus 57. So this becomes the commutative property. Now what I am going to do, I am going to make a bracket to solve it differently. For example, 196 plus 4, then plus 57, this becomes the associative property. 196 plus 4 is nothing but, if we add 4 to 196, it becomes 200. 200 plus 57, that is equal to 257. So this is the example 1 we have done. Now we are going to see the example 2. Now we are going to see the example 2. What he has given? He has given the multiplication. What is that? 5 into 9 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 5. Now we are going to rearrange this one. So what we, how we can rearrange this one? For example, 5 into 2 into 9 into 5 into 2 into 3. So I have rearranged. So this becomes a commutative property. Now I am going to make these numbers in the brackets. 5 into 2 bracket into 9, again 5 into 2 in bracket into 3. This becomes the associative property. So 5 into 2 is 10 into 9 into 5 into 2 is again 10 into 3. So 10 9s are 90 and 10 3s are is 30. Now we are going to do what is the answer we are going to find. 9 3s are is 27. We have to take this 0, 0. So the answer is 2700. Now we are going to try the some example problems he has given. We are going to try these example problems. We are going to do this one. So what is that in the first question? 319 plus 69 plus 81. Now we are going to rearrange the number. So we have to rearrange the number so that we get the answer very quick. So what here 9 is there. If we add 1, it becomes 10. No. So we have to see which is that number. So 81 is the number. We are going to arrange it like this. 319 plus 81 plus 69. So this becomes the commutative property. Now I am going to solve this in bracket separately. This becomes the associative property. So 319 plus 81 we are going to do here. 9 plus 1 is 10. 8 9 10 again. So this is 400. 400 plus 69. So that is equal to 469. Now we are going to do the second question. So what is that second question? So this one we are going to do. What is the question? 431 plus 37 plus 69 plus 63. Now we are going to rearrange this one as 431 plus 69 plus 37 plus 63. So this becomes a commutative property because we are rearranging such that we get the easiest answer. Now I am solving this in brackets. 431 plus 69 plus 37 plus 63. This becomes the associative property. So what is that 431 plus 69 we are going to do here? 431 plus 69. 9 plus 1 is 10, carry 1. 6 plus 3 plus 1, that is again 10. This becomes the 500. 4 plus 1 is 500. So this is 500 plus 37 plus 63. So 37 plus 63. What is that? 7 plus 3 is 10. 6 plus 3 is 9. Carry 1 is 10. So it is 100. What is the answer? Answer is 600. So now we are going to do the third question. The third question is of multiplication example. This one we are going to do. What is that question? 2 into 71 into 5. So this is the simple. We know how to rearrange 2 into 5 into 71. So this becomes a commutative property. 2 5s are 10. We already know, that is why we are arranging is like this. So we have to write it in brackets so that we get the answer easily. So this is associative property. So 2 into 5 is 10. 10 into 71. So 10 into 71 is 710. So this is our answer. Now we are going to do the fourth question. So what is that fourth question? 50 into 17 into 2. Now we have to rearrange that 50 into 2 into 17. So this becomes a commutative property. 50 into 2, I am writing in brackets, into 17. So this is the associative property. 50 into 2 is 100 into 17. I'm forgetting to give the equal. 100 into 17. What is that 100 into 17? 1700. So this is the answer. So we have solved this one. So with this, we have completed the example problems. Now we are going to see the another one. What is another one? Another property is distributive property of multiplication over addition. So what is this property we are going to see here? For example, what is that property? Distributive property of multiplication over addition. So what we have to do here? For example, he has given 5 into 4, that is equal to 2 into 4 plus 3 into 4. How is that possible? Now I am telling you 5. How we can write 5 as 2 plus 3? We can write 5 as 2 plus 3. No, 2 plus 3 is equal to 5 into 4. Now what he is doing, he is taking this 2 and multiplying with 4, that is 2 into 4. What is the sign here? Plus. We have to give plus here. Now again 3 into 4. This is the distributive property of multiplication over addition. Now we are going to see the result. You know that 5 into 4 is 20, I have written here. Now 2 into 4 is 8 plus 3 into 4 is 12. So what is that? 20 is equal to 8 plus 12 is also 20. So this is the property called distributive property of multiplication over addition. Now we are going to see the example 3. Example 3, what he has given? 12 into 75 using distributive property, he is saying. So this is the example 3, 12 into 75. So we have to solve the problem in the easiest way. We can write 75 as 70 plus 5. So now I have to split this one. What is that? 12 into 70 plus again 12 into 5. So what is that? 12 into 70. 12 sevens is 84 plus 12 fives is 60. So with this we can say that 840 plus 60 we have to write here. So 0 plus 0 is 0. 6 plus 4 is 10. 8 carry 1 is 9. So what is the answer? 900 is the answer. Here he has given some examples we are going to see, or we can see the other properties. So what is the other property? Other property is identity of multiplication and addition. So for addition, if a number is present, for example, if 1 is present, if we are adding 0 to it, it is the same number, that is 1. If a number is 9 is there, if we add 0, so what is the number? 9 only. So this property is called additive identity. So if we are adding 0 to any number, So we get the same number. That property is called additive identity. Now, if a number is present, 1, if we multiply that number with 1, we get the same number. For example, 2 is there. If we multiply the number with 1, we get the same number, that is 2. If a number is 16, 16 is the number. If we multiply it 1, we get the same number, that is 16. So what is that? This is the multiplicative identity. So what is multiplicative identity means? If a number is present, if we multiply that number with 1, we get the same number. That is called multiplicative identity. Now we are going to see that what all properties we have discussed from the beginning. So what is the first property we have discussed? We have discussed the first property as closure property. Next is commutative property. Then associative property. After associative property, we have seen the distributive property. After distributive property, that is identity of addition and multiplication. So additive identity and multiplicative identity. So with this we have seen the all properties, what whole numbers follow the properties, we have seen that. Now we are going to do the exercise. So exercise 2.2. In exercise 2.2, what he has given, give the results without actually performing the operation using the given information. So what is this first question here? 28 into 19 is equal to 532. So 19 into 28. So this property is nothing but the, which property? It is nothing but the commutative property. We get the same answer. So what is the first answer? Is nothing but 532. So this follows the commutative property. What is the second one? 1 into 47 is equal to 47. 47 into 1 is also 47. So this follows the multiplicative identity. Now the third question. What is the third question? A into B is equal to C. B into A is also equal to C. So this one, what is this property? Again the same one. What is that? Commutative property under multiplication. So this one is also commutative property under multiplication only. Now we are going to see the fourth question. What is this fourth question? 58 plus 42 is equal to 100. 42 plus 58 is also equal to this one we are doing, fourth one. 42 plus 58 is also equal to 100. So what is this property? This property is also a commutative property, but it is under addition. Now we are going to see the fifth question. What is that fifth question? 85 plus 0 is equal to 85. And 0 plus 85 is equal to 85 only. So what is this property? Here the property is additive identity. So if we add in 0 to any number, we get the same number. Now we are going to see the sixth question. What is this? A plus B is equal to D. B plus A is equal to D only. So this is nothing but commutative property under addition. Now we are going to see the second question. What is the second question? In second question, find the sum by suitable rearrangement. So we are doing this second question. In the second question, first one, 238 plus 695 plus 162. So now we have to rearrange these numbers to get the answer easily. So how we have to rearrange 238 plus 162 plus 695? So this is commutative property. We have rearranged the numbers. Now I am going to do it separately, like 238 plus 162 under brackets plus 695. So this becomes the associative property. Now I am going to do it separately, 238, 162, addition. So 8 plus 2 is 10, carry 1. 6 plus 3 is 9, carry 1 is again 10. 2 plus 1 plus 1, that is 2 plus 1 is 3, carry 1 is 4. So this becomes the 400. 400 plus 695. Now I have to do that. 400 plus 695. 695 plus 400. 5 plus 0 is 5. 9 plus 0 is 9. 6 plus 4 is 10. So what is the answer? 1095 is the answer. Now we are going to do the second question. So what is that second question? This one we are doing. What is that question? 154 plus 197 plus 46 plus 203. So first, what we have to do? We have to rearrange this one. So we have to rearrange such that we get the easiest answer. See, this one is 4 and this one is 6. So if we combine 4, 6, we get 10. So we have to rearrange these numbers by side. 46, then 197 plus 203. So this becomes a commutative property. Now I am going to separate these numbers as 154 plus 46 under bracket plus 197 plus 203. Under brackets, this becomes the associative property. Now I'm going to add these separately. 154 plus 46, that is 46 is 10, 5 plus 4 is 9, carry 1 is 10, this is 200. Plus I'm going to add this 197 plus 203 separately. So 7 plus 3 is 10, 9 plus carry 1 is also 10, 2 plus 1 is 3, carry 1 is 4, this is 400. So what is the answer? 600 is the answer. 200 plus 400 is 600. Now we are going to see the third question. What is the third question? Now we are going to do this third question. Find the product by suitable rearrangement, he is asking. So how we can do that in the third question? The first one, 25 into 1963 into 4. So we have to rearrange as such we get the easiest answer. What is this? 25 into 4 into 1963. So 25 into 4, we know 25 into 4 is 25. If you don't know, means we have to do here. 4 5 is 20, 4 2 is 8, 9 carry 2 is 10. So 100. 100 into 1963. So 1963 into 100 means 1963 100, like this. So this is the easiest way of finding the answer. Now we are going to see the second question of this. So what is the second question? We are going to do this one. (20 × 255 × 50 × 6). So what is that? Now we are going to rearrange 20 × 50 × 255 × 6. So this becomes the commutative property, and now we are going to make it separate. 20 × 50 separate into 255 × 6 separate. So this becomes the associative property. So 20 × 50. So 2 5 is 10. This 0 we have to write, and this 0 we have to write. So this becomes a 1000 into 255 × 6. So what is this 255 × 6? We have to do here 255 × 6. 6 5 is 30. 6 5 is 30. Carry 3 is 33. 6 2 are 12. Carry 3 is 15. Now we have to write here 1000 × 1530. So what is the answer? 1530, and we have to write this 3 zeros here. So this is the answer. Now we are going to see the fourth and fifth question. So what is this fourth and fifth question we are going to see here? Now we are going to do the fourth and fifth question. So we have to take the another slide. So what is this fourth and fifth question? Find the value of the following, he is asking. What is that? Find the value of the following. So what he has given in the fourth one, first one, 368 × 12 plus 18 × 368. So by seeing this, what we can say that this is the distributive property, because we can see that the either side of plus we are having 368. So I'm going to take 368 as common, and this becomes 12 plus 18. So 368 12 plus 18. What is 12 plus 18? 12 plus 18 is nothing but 30. Now we are going to do as 368 × 30. We have to do here into 30. What is that? 0 8 is 0 0 6 is 0 0 3 is 0. Now 3 8 is 24. 3 6 is 18 19 20. 3 3 is 9 10 11. So this is the answer, 040. So what is the answer? 11040 is the answer. Now we are going to see the second question. So what is this second question? Here, this one. What is that? 79 × 4319 plus 4319 × 11. So we can say that on either side of the plus we are having 4319. So I'm going to take 4319 as common. Now it becomes 79 plus 11. So 4319, 79 plus 11 is 90. So 4319 × 90 we have to do. I'm going to do here separate 4319 × 9. 9 9 is 81. 9 1 is 9, carry 8 is 17, 9 3 is 27, carry 1 is 28, 9 4 is 36, carry 2 is 38. So what is the answer? 38871, and we have to keep this 0. So this is the answer. Now we are going to do the fifth question. So what is fifth question? Find the product using suitable property. This one. In this we are going to do this first one, fifth one, first one. So 205 into 1989. What is that? 205 into 1989. So we have to do multiplication so that we get the answer in the easiest way. So how we can do that? 205 into 1989 is there. So I can write 1989 as 2000 minus 11. So I can write like this now. So after this, what I have to do? 205 into, this is the distributive property we have made. So 205 into 2000 minus 205 into 11. Now I'm going to do the multiplication of both the sides. What is that? On either side of the subtraction. So 205 into 2000, 205 into 2. This 205 into 2 is nothing but, we are going to do here for your understanding, 205 into 2. 2 5 is 10, 2 0 is a 0, carry 1 is 1, 2 2 is a 4. So this is 410. 410, and we have to keep this 3 zeros, that is thousands, minus 205 into 11. I am doing here 205 into 11. 1 5 is a 5, 1 0 is a 0, 1 2 is a 2. Again, 1 5 is a 5, 1 0 is a 0, 1 2 is a 2. So 5 5 2 2. So what is this answer? 2 2 5 5. Now we have to do the subtraction. 4 1 0 0 0 0 minus 2 2 5. We have to do the subtraction. So I have to do subtraction means this is 0, I have to take borrow. So this becomes 0, this is 10, again 9, this is 10, again 9, this becomes 10, 9, and this becomes 10. So 10 minus 5 is 5, 9 minus 5 is 4, 9 minus 2 is 7, 9 minus 2 is 7, 0 as it is, again 4. So what is our answer means? 407745 is the answer. Now we are going to do the second question. So what is the second question? In the fifth one, second question we are doing 1991 into 1005. So how I can write 1991 as 2000 minus 9 into 1005? So this is again the distributive property. Now I have to write as 2000 into 1005 minus 9 into 1005. So 2000 into 1005. For this, we have to write here 1005 into 2. So 2 5 is 10, 2 0 is a 0, carry 1 is 1, 2 0 is a 0, 2 1 is a 2. This becomes 2010, and we have to keep this zeros. Minus 1005, we have to do here now. 1005 into 9. 9 5 is 45. 9 0 is a 0, carry 4 is 4, 9 0 is a 0, 9 1 is a 9. So what is the answer? 9045 is the answer. So now we have to do the subtraction. 201000 minus 9045. Now I'm going to take the borrow, this becomes 0, this becomes 10. Again, I have to take borrow. 10 minus 5 is 5, 9 minus 4 is also 5. Again, 9 minus 0 is 9, 9 minus 9 is 0, 0, 0, 2. So this is the answer. 2000955 is the answer. Now we are going to do the 6th and 7th question. So what is this 6th question? A milk vendor supplies 56 liters of milk in the morning and 44 liters of milk in the evening to a hostel. If the milk costs 30 rupees per liter, how much money he gets per day? So we are going to solve this 6th question. So what is this 6th question? Already we have read. So what milk vendors do? Milk vendor supplies 56 liter of milk in the morning. So milk supplied in morning. That is equal to 56 liters. And milk supplied in evening. That is equal to 44 liters. Now, what is he saying? If the milk costs 30 rupees per liter. So what is the cost of milk? Cost of milk per liter. That is equal to 30 rupees. What he is saying? How much money he gets per day? So we don't know that. So first we are going to see that how much milk he is supplying in a day. So milk supplied per day is equal to morning plus evening. So that is equal to 56 plus 44. So that is equal to 100 liters. So what is asking? What is the question? How much money he gets per day? So money per day. So we don't know. We are going to take it as X. So what is that cost of milk? That is per liter. 1 liter milk is equal to 30 rupees. So what is that 100 liter? 100 liter milk is equal to X. Now we have to do this cross multiplication. So what is this cross multiplication? 1 into x is equal to 30 into 100. So x is equal to 1 into x is x. X is equals to 30 into 100. That is 30 into 100 is nothing but 3000. So the milk vendor gets 3000 rupees. 3000 rupees per day. So this is the answer. Now we are going to see the 7th one. So what is this 7th question? Chandana and Venu purchase 12 notebooks and 10 notebooks respectively. The cost of each book is 15 rupees. Then how much money should they pay to the shopkeeper? So we are doing this 7th question. So what is that? Chandana and Venu purchase 12 notebooks and 10 notebook respectively. Means nothing but Chandana purchase 12 books and Venu purchase 10 books. Cost of each book is equal to 15 rupees. So cost of total books, we don't know, we are going to take it as x, but we know the quantity. So total books is equal to Chandana plus Venu, that is 12 plus 10, that is equal to 22 books. So for one book it is 15 rupees, for 22 books we don't know, we are going to take it as x. Now we have to do the cross multiplication. So what is this cross multiplication? 1 into x is equal to 22 into 15. So x is equal to, now we have to do here separately, 22 into 15. So 5 2s are 10, carry 1. 5 2s are 10, carry 1 is 11. 1 2s are 2, 1 2s are 2. So 0, 3, 3. So what is the answer? They have paid 330 rupees to the shopkeeper. Now we are going to see the 8th question. What is 8th question? So what is 8th question? He has given the match the following in this question. 1991 plus 7 is equal to 7 plus 1991. So this property is nothing but commutative property under addition. So I am writing here as where is commutative property, commutative under addition? See, 8th question. Next is 68 into 50 is equals to 50 into 68. So this is nothing but commutative property under multiplication. That is E. 1. 1 is nothing but multiplicative identity. 0. 0 is nothing but additive identity. Last is 875 into 100. Plus 30 is equal to 879 into 100 plus 879 into 30. This is distributive property. So distributive property of multiplication over addition. This is equal to D. With this, we have completed exercise 2.2. Now we are going to see the patterns in the whole numbers. What are different patterns in whole numbers? We are going to see. What are different patterns in whole numbers? There is line pattern, rectangle pattern, square pattern, triangle pattern. So we are going to represent this by dots. So for this, I'm going to take example. What is that example? If we are having two dots like this, so I can represent two as these dots. So these are in line. So if I am having three dots, I can represent in line. So this is also a line. If I am having four dots like this, I can represent it in square. If I am having six, so I can represent this as rectangle. So if we get the number increase, so we can represent these in different shape. For example, if we are having 6, so we can represent as triangle also like this. You can see here, so this is a triangle. So if we are having 6 means we can represent this in triangle also. So here he has given which numbers can be represented in line, rectangle, square and triangle. Now we are going to see the different other patterns which are used in whole numbers. So here we are going to see this one, patterns of numbers. So what is this pattern? 296 plus 9. I am solving the first one. 296 plus 9. How I can write 296 plus 9? 296 plus, how I can write 9 as 10 minus 1. So that is equal to 296 into 10 plus, oh sorry, here it is minus, no, we have to take minus. 296 plus 10, sorry, I'm writing it again. So 296 plus 10 plus, and then it is minus 1. So what is this? 296 plus 10 is, this is equal to 306 minus 1, that is equal to 305. So this is the pattern we can make for different numbers. Now I am going to write this in the one sequence. For what we have seen, for this 296 plus 9 is equal to 296 plus 10 minus 1 is equal to 306 minus 1 is equal to 305. Now if the number is 296 plus 99, so how I have to write 296 plus 100 minus 1, that is equal to 396 minus 1, that is equal to 395. Now if I repeat this for 296 plus 999, so 296 plus 999, how I can write that? 1000 minus 1, so it is equal to 1000 minus 1. So 296 plus 1000 is nothing but 1296 minus 1. So 1296 minus 1 is 1295. With this we can make different patterns. This is for addition. Now we are going to see for multiplication. This is for multiplication. 65 into 99 is equal to 65 into 99. How we can write 100 minus 1? So 100 minus 1 is nothing but 6500 minus 65. So we have, this is the distributive property. First we have to take this one, 65 into 100, then we have to take this one, 65 into 1. So this is nothing but 6435. This is the answer. If we go further for this number, 65 into 999 means it becomes 65 into 1000 minus 1. That is nothing but 65,000 minus 65. This is nothing but 64935. This is the pattern of the number. Now we are going to see for exercise 2.3. So what is exercise 2.3? In exercise 2.3 we are going to see the first question. Exercise 2.3. So in exercise 2.3, first question, study the pattern he is saying. So what is the pattern? 1 into 8 plus 1. Now 1 into 8 plus 1 is equal to 9. This is the question only. 12 into 8 plus 2 is equal to 98. Then 1, 2, 3 into 8 plus 3 is equals to 987. By seeing this we can understand what is that. So the 1 is there, we are getting 9. instead of 1, if we are getting 2, here beside 1 we are getting 2, that becomes 9, 8. Again he is increasing the number as 3, so we are getting 1, 2, 3 here, and 9, 8, 7 is the number. Now I am going to write 1, 2, 3, 4 into 8 plus 4. So what is that? 9, 8, 7, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 into 8 plus 5 is equals to 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. Now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 into 8 plus 6 is equals to 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. Now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 into 8 plus 7 is equals to 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 into 8 plus 8 is equals to 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Now I am going to write till 9. 1, 2, 3, 4. In the first question, we have seen the pattern as 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, like this. Now we are going to see the second question. So what is this second question? Here we are doing this one. What is this? 91 into 11 into 1 is equal to 1001. 91 into 11 into 2 is equal to 2002. 91 into 11 into 3 is equal to 3003. This means that 91 into 11 for 91 into 11 is equal to 1001. If we multiply any number with this, we are going to get that number. 91 into 11 into 4 means 4004. 91 into 11 into 5 is nothing but 5005. 91 into 11 into 6, 6006. 91 into 11 into 7 is nothing but 7007. And one more pattern he has given to find out. What is that? We are going to see. So try the pattern 143 into 7. 143 into 7 into 1. So now we are going to do that. 143 into 7. 7 threes are 21. 7 2s are 14. Carry 2 is 7 4s are 28. Carry 2 is 30. 7 1s are 7. Carry 3 is 10. So 1001. So 1001 into 1 is nothing but 1001. 143 into 7 into 2 is nothing but 2002. 143 into 7 into 3 is equal to 3003. 143 into 7 into 4 is equal to 4004. 143 into 7 into 5 is equal to 5005. 143 into 7 into 6 is equal to 6006. 143 into 7 into 7 is equal to 7007. Now we are going to do the third question. Now we are going to do the third question. What is this third question? How would we multiply the number this one with 9 mentally? What is the pattern that emerges, he is asking. So what is that number? We are going to do the third question. What is that number? 1, 3, 6, 8, 0, 3, 4, 7 is the number if we multiply with 9. So how I can write 9? 1, 3, 6, 8, 0, 3, 4, 7 into 9 means it is nothing but 10 minus 1. So 1, 3, 6, 8, 0, 3, 4, 7 into 10 minus 1, 3, 6, 8, 0, 3, 4, 7 into 1. So 1, 3, 6, 8, 0, 3, 4, 7, 0 minus 1, 3, 6, 8, 0, 3, 4, 7. Now I have to do the subtraction. So what is that subtraction? 1, 3, 6, 8, 0, 3, 4, 7, 0. Don't get confused with these two numbers, because this number is having extra 0. This number is not having 0 because we are multiplying with 10. Now I'm going to write again 1, 3, 6, 8, 0, 3, 4, 7. Now I'm going to do the subtraction. So for subtraction, I need borrow. This becomes 9. 10 minus 7 is 3. 9 minus 4 is 5. 4 minus 3 is 1. Oh. Sorry, this is 6. So 6 minus 4 is 2. And again 3 minus 0 is 3. I have to take borrow. 10 minus 8 is 2. This becomes 7. 7 minus 6 is 1. Then again 6 minus 3 is 3. So 3 minus 1 is 2. 1 as it is. So what is the pattern he is asking? 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3 is the answer. So now we have to do for the remaining numbers. So what is the other number? Next number, 3, 5, 7, 0, 2, 3, 6, 9 into 9. So how I can write this one? 3, 5, 7, 0, 2, 3, 6, 9 into 10 minus 1. So what is this? 3, 5, 7, 0, 2, 3, 6, 9, 0, 6, 9 into 10 minus 3, 5, 7, 0, 2, 3, 6, 9 into 1. So what this number become? 3, 5, 7, 0, 2, 3, 6, 9, 0 minus 3, 5, 7, 0, 2, 3, 6, 9. Now I'm going to do the subtraction. 3, 5, 7, 0, 2, 3, 6, 9, 0. 3, 5, 7, 0, 2, 3, 6, 9. I have to do the subtraction. So this becomes 8. 10 minus 9 is 1. 8 minus 6 is 2. 6 minus 3 is 3. 3 minus 2 is 1. 2 minus 0 is 2. Again, I have to take borrow. This becomes 10 minus 7 is 3. This becomes 6. 6 minus 5 is 1. 5 minus 3 is 2. 3. So what is the pattern here means? 3, 2, 1, 3, 2, 1, 3, 2, 1. This is the pattern. Now, what is the last number we have to do? We are going to do that one. So, what is this last number? The last number is 2, 5, 6, 9, 2, 3, 5, 9. We have to multiply with 9. So, what is the number? 2, 5, 6, 9, 2, 3, 5, 9 into 10 minus 1. So 2, 5, 6, 9, 2, 3, 5, 9 into 10 minus 2, 5, 6, 9, 2, 3, 5, 9 into 1. This becomes 2, 5, 6, 9, 2, 3, 5, 9, 0 minus 2, 5, 6, 9, 2, 3, 5, 9. Now I'm going to do the subtraction. 2, 5, 6, 9, 2, 3, 5, 9, 0. 2, 5, 6, 9, 2, 3, 5, 9. I have to take borrow. This becomes 8. 10 minus 9 is 1. 8 minus 5 is 3. 5 minus 3 is 2. 3 minus 2 is 1. I have to take borrow. 12 minus 9 is 3. This becomes 8. 8 minus 6 is 2. 6 minus 5 is 1. 5 minus 2 is 3. 2. So what is the pattern arises means here 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1. So with this we have completed this exercise and also the chapter of whole numbers. Thank you.